Does that then mean that you don't also believe that no money has been recovered from anyone whatsoever?
No, well, I'm not saying I don't believe that no money has been recovered. I don't know how they recovered money. I don't know who they recovered money. But one thing I know is that if you arrest me and you lock me up in an underground cell and you intimidate me, you harass me with every possible state power like they are doing with people, even people who genuinely receive campaign funds and who must have utilized them, they will go and borrow the money and give you back just to have peace. That is the situation that we see in.
So you mean if they will arrest you now maybe on something that they think they have a case, even if you think they don't have a case, you borrow the money and return so you can have peace?
You see,
would you do that yourself?
No, you see, I may be different because.
So you
will. Hold on. The truth is, I may not do so, but we cannot all be the same. There are people that have health issues. Most of these people they arrest are elderly people. They have high blood pressure. They have this. They have that. So just to have peace of mind, they will definitely return money that probably they've used for campaign or for the assignment for which they were sent. You see, the reason why we must bring equity to the fight against corruption is that these same rules will be used to judge this government when they leave office.
But you know, they've not fully delved into what happens with the NNPC as well. So if that happens, would you also say that's persecution?
You see, for instance, the head of NNPC today was someone who has been in NNPC for such a long time, such a very long time.
Does that matter?
It does matter. You see,
they're investigating what happened with funds, will it matter?
Of course it does, because the structure of NNPC is such that every organ of NNPC.
You think he'll be waved aside if he himself had questions to answer?
Look at Boratai, for example. This government actually protects corruption. Look at what is happening in the House of Assembly, House of Reps, where an APC rep member is boldly challenging the Speaker of the House of Reps on corruption.
Have you petitioned anyone based on that yourself?
Did EFCC need...
No, because this is what you've been reading as well.
Did EFCC need any petition against Olusanmetu?
What if they denied?
Did EFCC need any petition?
Have you not heard them deny
against
that?
Against Femi Fanikayode?
We've heard them deny. You didn't buy that denial.
Didn't Femi Fanikayode deny before he was investigated that he did not do anything wrong? Didn't Olusanmetu deny that he did not do anything wrong? Were they not arrested? Were they not intimidated? Were they not prosecuted? Were they not charged to court? Are they not being prosecuted?
Has your party written a petition about those allegations?
Do we need to write a petition against Boratai? Okay. Do we?
I'm talking about the House of Reps. The House of Reps. Haven't you written?
Do we need to write a petition? What is the work of EFCC in this fight
against
corruption?
If they don't do it, wouldn't you then say, well, since you're not investigating, I'm writing and I've written and I can prove that I wrote and you didn't do anything? Wouldn't that add to the whole
impotency? You see, our problem with the present administration is that before they came to power, they had solutions to every Nigerian problem. But now that they're in power, they have excuse for every problem.
The Jadeonju is a member of the People's Democratic Party. Thank you for talking to us today on the program.
Thank you very
much. And then don't forget, the Channels 24 app, we still have to focus on that. Just one more time before we wrap up.
You want me to flip this iPad again?
Sure. We did it before.
Some people were wondering what was wrong with the iPad. Okay, that's it. There. You see,
I can't see anything wrong with it.
That's a live feed, and then that's a social media feed. Some of the features you will now find on the regular Channels app. The Channels TV app. But you see, why we're doing this is because you can watch us everywhere you are, anywhere in the world. You have both the live feed and then you have the social media feed showing on the screen right there. Our audience in the diaspora, any part of the world, you can use this app, the Channels TV, Channels 24 app. That's what it is. It's different from the Channels TV app. But if you're in Nigeria, you can also download it, although you might not really enjoy it as much as those in the diaspora. But download the two apps and use them. I have the two of them.
But I can bet they'll enjoy the future.
When that future
yeah
comes on board,
I know they will.
You wouldn't, you wouldn't want to use anything else.
But you have to hold on for that.
Start
one.
Now. Just pick it up now.
It's, I mean, it will help your loved ones. That's what.
Really, really interesting.
It's something you can use, actually.
You get to see the social media feed. What's on our website?
Right,
also,
I know you will go on.
No.
Well, that's how we have to wrap the show up today. We appreciate your comments and thank you for watching as well. Yeah, we can come back now. We'll see you next time. I'm Chamberlain Osa.
Thank you. I'm Maope Ogun.
And I'm Neo Taigwe. Do remember the channel's 24-hour app. Go download it.